Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to add the Panda Status and the Panda Branch to my P1S. So let's start by looking what's in the box of the Panda Branch. There's the ducky, AMS connection cable. Instead of an instruction manual, we have a QR code to the WIKI page. And some screws to assemble the casing and attach it to the printer. Finally, we get to the Panda Branch itself, and its purpose is very simple. You get 4 5-volt USB ports and 4 AMS ports. Let's move on to the Panda Status. We have some tape scattered in the package. This is used to secure your connection cable. Then we have the connection cable, an alcohol pad, the PCB controller, and watch out, the antenna is delicate. Then we have a dry cleaning cloth, a PTFE tube silicon plug with a hole for the USB cable, the USB cable, some 3M double-sided tape, and some more other tape. And finally, the Panda Status itself. And when the unboxing is finished, we need to download some files from Makerworld to create a case for the Panda Branch and a case for the PCB controller for the Panda Status. Now we have put the Panda Branch in the case, we can use the provided screws to lock this down. In the background, you can see me assemble the standard files provided by BIQU. Later on in the video, I will use the files I created myself and the reason why I created these files. Now the Panda Branch is ready to install, and we're going to use those two screws to attach it to the printer. We are going to do the same for the Panda Status controller, download a file from Makerworld, print the case, and put the part in. Be careful with putting this part in, because again, the antenna part is really sensitive. After this, we get to the final preparations, and that is removing the lid and removing the print bed from the printer. Now it's also time to open the Panda Status Wiki page to get step-by-step instruction on the installation. You can also find the links to the downloaded files here. You have multiple options on where to install your controller in your printer. I chose this option, and be sure to put your USB-C cable in. Now we're going to attach the connection cable and route it all the way left. And to make sure it stays there, we're going to use the provided tape to stick it onto the ledge. Here we're going to route it down with the other cables into the back of the printer, and the rest of the cable we're gonna stick it down again with the provided tape. The method I'm using is stick it on the bottom and then fold it over the top. Now we're going to route the rest of the cable, and before we can do that we have to remove the whole back cover. We're going to start with the PTFE tube silicone plug. We're going to replace this with the one provided. You can also choose to install the cable in plain sight, but I didn't like that, so this is the way I go. I made the mistake to test fit the silicone plug. Don't make the same mistake and put it back in when you put back the back cover. We are going to fast forward me removing the back cover, but remember that removing the plug and all the cables beforehand makes this job a lot easier. Now you see me fiddling the cable through, and I will realize in a few moments that it's easier when I remove the back cover completely. Then you see the pictures of where you can attach your cable and run it beside the other cables that are already there. This last picture is very important. Put it through the hole so it's centered underneath the bed. And after that, you can close the back cover again, put the plug in, and we can continue the process. Now we're going to reinstall the filament buffer, and we're going to use my new design. And why I made this new design, you see it here in the background, because the original cables are too short. So I decided to create a new mount, and I put that on Makerworld. Link will be in the description below. Here's where we print it, and now we're going to install it on top of the filament buffer. And yes, before you ask, those are really long screws. And after we put in the USB cable, let's do some cable management and continue on the front. Before we stick on the Panda Status, we have to clean it real thoroughly with the alcohol wipe, and then we have to dry it off with the cloth. While I'm cleaning it in the background, take your time to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. If you hear someone talking in the background, that's correct. That's my little boy. He's playing Call of Duty and he doesn't know the sound limits. Also, be sure to be careful when you stick it on. It took me 3 times and it's a pain to get it off when you stick it on. Then we're going to take a look at the route the cable is taking underneath. Use the tape to stick it down. And when that's done, we're gonna reinstall the plate and the cover, and it's time to turn the printer on. I swear, I almost started talking to my watch. And now that everybody has a good indication of my age, let's bind it to our printer. First, we're going to connect to the Panda Status access point and use the default password 987654321. After we connect it, we get rerouted to the configuration. We're gonna scan for Wi-Fi networks and choose our own network. Then fill in the password and connect to the Wi-Fi. After that's successful, we're gonna bind the printer. We are going to let the Panda Status scan for our printers, and this is gonna take about 35 seconds. If everything goes well, you'll see all your printers in the list and you can select the one you want it attached to. Then in the background, I'm searching for the access code and you have to fill it in. And then when the binding is successful, you can change the options. I will change to HDD first, just to see how it looks. Now let's change it back to music and see how it reacts.
Check, 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 pow!
It has a built-in microphone and the lights will react to the sounds inside your printer. I like this feature, but now what it looks like during a print. I think it's a real benefit, and in one glimpse you can see how far your print is or what the status of your printer is. And these colors are fully customizable. You can see the example in the right top. When I change the colors, it's real time, and I think that's a real benefit too. This is a list with all the standard colors programmed, like when it's downloading, preparing to print, during the print, when it's done, when there's an error, or when it's on standby. I really love this feature. I think it's an aesthetic plus to your printer. It won't make your printer print better, but I really think it's a plus. The Panda Branch is a must-have when you are in need of the extra ports. And now we came to the end of the video. I want to thank my Patreons for supporting me and my channel. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel. You can support me in many ways. Links are in the description. I thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next.